How businesses are faring in the pandemic. I'm joined live via Skype by Anthony Cambas. He's the Mississippi Small Business Development Center Manager of International Trade at the University of Mississippi. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So as we look at the number of businesses that have restructured, struggled, or gone out of business completely, which types of businesses have been the hardest hit?
Well, I think obviously businesses that have direct contact with people, so restaurants, hotels, any type of tourism-related businesses, airlines, et cetera, even entertainment. So there's been a large impact on live entertainment as well.
And even though we have heard good news about potential vaccines coming up, which sectors do you expect to bounce back in 2021, given that this is a health crisis-fueled economic downturn versus a more traditional recession?
Well, that's a great question, and I think that we're still kind of finding our answers because there's no absolutes at this point. The situation is still fluid and very dynamic and ever-changing, but I think the sectors that are going to bounce back are those that provide essential needs to people and essential comforts. So, of course, food, clothing, shelter, those types of businesses, but also human beings need to be able to have entertainment and have relaxation and other types of guest pleasure. So I think there's going to be a combination of both necessities as well as kind of pleasures.
And we have seen that recessions and economic downturns have also historically led to business ingenuity. Companies including Microsoft, Hyatt Hotels, Uber and Airbnb all started under very strained economies. We even saw Zoom overtake other established video conferencing companies during this pandemic. So which sectors or countries do you see that happening the most under these conditions?
Well, what I can see, and I know people all over the world, is that really almost every country on the face of the earth is really innovating at this point because people are finding solutions. They're thrown into difficult situations. Existing businesses, restaurants, for instance, I've seen restaurants that are also selling products for people to pick up, such as barbecue sauce that they may have used on their products. So I think it's a worldwide thing that we're seeing. Of course, a lot of technologies are being used, e-commerce, and there's a lot of opportunities. There's a lot of ingenuity and innovation around the world in the United States, Africa, China, Latin America, really everywhere. I'm seeing that.
And so as we're seeing people, especially people who've been laid off, seeking other opportunities, how sustainable are some of these new businesses?
Well, that also is going to depend on a lot of things. And one of them, I believe, is receiving assistance to help them. So there are programs in most countries now that are responding to COVID by providing assistance to small and medium-sized businesses and entrepreneurs. Also beyond the level of state and national governments, we're also seeing the United Nations, for instance, in the area of international trade, the International Trade Center in Geneva has been very active, I've seen, since the COVID situation really started taking its toll.
So you mentioned the sorts of funding. What's really needed, though, for a lot of these people who sort of got into business without really knowing what they were doing? It was really more out of necessity. What do you think will really help make or break their success in 2021 and beyond?
Well, first, I'd say funding can be important, but if companies or entrepreneurs do not know how to run a business and do not understand finance, then the funding in of itself is not enough. So funding is going to be a key part of it, but also the assistance that's provided to small, medium-sized businesses. So for 2021, I think that people are going to kind of wait and see, and it may vary by country and even in countries, different regions. So some will be, you know, sticking their head out of the door and saying, wow, there's bright sunshine out here. We're ready to rock and roll. Let's bring tourism. Let's start innovating again. Let's really try to get back, quote, to normal. But I think the new normal, quote unquote, as everyone refers to, does not necessarily have to be a scary thing. I think there's a lot of things that can be left behind from the lessons learned to help businesses be more savvy and be able to adapt. Because this is one situation, but it's not going to be the last type of either disaster or unexpected situation. So business continuity is going to be crucial as well.
And recent surveys do show that CEOs are somewhat optimistic about the road ahead. So will businesses have the capital to invest in 2021? And will they want to? Or will next year be more about trying to recoup losses?
Yes, in my opinion, there will be capital be invested. It's going to depend on the company and the sector that they're in. But yes, I think a lot of decisions have been made to hold back in some cases on investment. And so kind of wait and see how 2021 shakes out. But I do believe that once we have a better lay of the land, so to speak, that we're going to see globally a lot of active investment.
Now, as we look at some of the trends that were happening before the pandemic, we saw that fear of missing out saw a lot of optimism about companies like WeWork and these other companies having these big IPOs. How has the pandemic and concerns about some of these overhyped IPOs before that really affected investor appetite?
Well, I think that, as I'm saying, people are going to want to wait and see. So the same thing with any kind of launch of a new company or a new technology. I think that all of us are waiting to see. So that would also be investors and others. So hype and promise of a great future doesn't necessarily mean that that's going to be the best business to invest in. So I think you're going to see more caution than you did in the past because we're waiting to see that everything is going to be in a way that's going to be sustainable.